That should be pretty good. Now when you're putting these back, that's open. See how this is moving? As you go, that pushes in and then hits the seat down below. I'm going to see if I can take a look at the seat. Hopefully we don't need to change that, but that's another video. But when you're putting these back in, make sure your plunger with the washer on it is all the way up to the top. That way when you're screwing it all in, you don't accidentally, like if this is all the way down there, you're trying to tighten this and it's over tightening your washer, and then you just got to do this in a week or two. We'll get ourselves a little bit of Teflon tape. Don't really need a whole heck of a lot. I got some static issues here, it's sticking to me. It has such a magnetic personality. When I fixed my water hammer, I kind of told you what to do with Teflon tape. Now I'm going to show you. This threads in this way. So you want your bottom to start here. Just kind of hold it for your first wrap. And just like a wrap and a half, maybe two maximum. Run your fingers along it just to get it into the grooves, if you can see the grooves. And now this way, when I screw it in, it's not going to back itself off because it's facing that direction too. So I got no frayed ends going against the grain, so to speak. We'll get the other one done here. Which one was this, hot or cold? Wrong. I don't even know if I'm in camera, but yeah, one wrap, one and a half or two or so. Rip that off, run it through, got some thread showing. You don't want to overdo that because then it'll just end up pushing it out. Just a thin one, or well, it should go around itself at least once, but don't go too overboard or it's just going to push its way back out the threads. What I'm doing is checking the seat. Ooh. I see the problem, or feel it anyway. These bottom up on a smooth, supposedly, round surface, and that's called the seat. So the washer pops against the seat. I just put my finger down this one and cut it all the hell. It's almost going to fall off. And I can feel some roughness on that. But because I didn't come prepared to change a seat, that's going to have to stay. But basically, seats are fairly easy too. They got, we'll get into that some other time. And like I say and everything else, don't cross thread stuff. Be patient. If you're finding it starting to get hard, then turn that porno off. But yeah, don't force it through because it could be just sticky threads or you could be cross threading it. So take it out, clean the threads, and try again. And save the porn for the those internet whack jobs. So I got all this finger tight. All I'm going to do is tighten her all up. And again, no need to over tighten stuff. When I turn the water back on, we'll check, because there'll be two different areas that it's gonna leak. It's either gonna leak from here or it's gonna leak from there. I know it's not going to leak from there. So when we turn the water back on, we just check this. If it's leaking, tighten it up a bit. Stop leaking? Good. If not, tighten it up a bit. Because no matter what, when you turn the water on, it's not going to be like Niagara Falls anyway, so. So just give her... all it needs. Blah, 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 you get the message. Okay, once you got them pretty much finger tight or whatever, once you bottomed out, do a nice little, just a bit of one. And what we'll do is we'll leave that for now. And when I turn the water back on, we'll see if it leaks. I can already tell just by finger closing that it's seating up nicely. This one's going to need a new seat, but I think what we'll do is we'll get a whole new sinking, or a whole new tap, and that'll solve that. Let's turn the water on and see if we all drown. Well, apparently we don't require gills, so that might need another little bit of a tightening. Let's take a peek in there. I don't know if that's just water that came out of the boat, or if that's water actually coming from there. Well, we gotta reef this down, because that's what you gotta do. You gotta reef it as hard as you can. Kidding. We apparently have no leaks. So, just pop those back on, and you're good to go. Ta-da.
Because there's nothing there to see. I'm hoping I get home. I am close to home. AnnaLytical was going to give me some gas money, but I opted against it after the other stuff she gave me for coming down and helping her out. And I just did not have the heart to say, oh, I'm going to have some gas money, please. But I'm going to do a whole new video on that, because it's kind of exciting for me anyway, what she gave me, and I really appreciate it. I am on the outskirts of Keswick. At least if I run out of gas, I'm about a 10 minute walk from home now, I think. Maybe 15 minutes. Whoa, look at this. Welcome to Keswick. Don't blink, or you are going to miss it. But we're way up there in the big time, because we got the McDonald's. Yeah. But if you got a McDonald's, you're a city. Or a gas station. Or a Walmart. I guess there's a McDonald's everywhere, isn't there? Anyway. Man. I think I'm gonna make it.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna make it. It's not getting even closer and closer.
Alright.
Ciao for now!